A pair of shoes normally sells for $100. The shoes are out of style, so they're going to be put on a sale with 10% off the regular price. And each day that they aren't sold, the price will decrease another 10%. How much will the shoes cost in 5 days? So you're repeatedly taking off 10%. That's exponential decay. So we're going to use the exponential model. F of x equals ab to the x. And there are a couple different ways to think about this decay model. You could think of this as is with a positive exponent and b has to be between 0 and 1. Or you could think of it as f of x equals ab to the negative x and b is greater than 1. Those are two equivalent forms of the same decay function. Okay, I'm going to go with the first one. So we're going to do f of t, function of time. The initial amount is $100, that's A. And then the rate of decay is 10% off. And so that means your decay factor is 1 minus your rate, or 90%, or 0.9. So our B is 0.90, and then I'll put to the T. Now, this can be kind of confusing, but when you're buying shoes, you're interested in the amount you pay. So what's happening is you're taking 10% off, but this 0.90 is what's left of the price you have to pay, and that's why the output is the price. So we're going to input 5 days to find how much the shoes will cost in 5 days. So F of 5 equals 100. Times 0.90 to the 5, or to the 5th power. Let's get a calculator. Okay, $59 and, see, 0.049 cents, so I'll put 59.05. So that means your answer is going to be 59.05. And they may just round the price to $59, who knows, with a sale they probably don't care about 5 cents. Let's review the process. We started off with our general exponential model after we realized it was an exponential model. And then we set up using our rate of decay, inputted the time, and then used the calculator to figure out the new cost of the shoes.